Thanks, everybody, for gathering virtually on this issue. It's really, really a tough one. In many ways, I think it's the hardest issue I've ever worked on. The reason I say that is not because there isn't potential. The potential of South Sudan is extraordinary. Extraordinary. And it is not because it isn't the right thing to do. It's absolutely the right thing to do, that all of us should be fighting and working to ensure that the people of South Sudan get the dignity that they deserve. I think the thing that makes it the hardest is, even in really tough issues I've worked on, conflicts, policies that are stuck, political infighting, I don't know that I've ever seen one where there is such a small amount of concern, if any, for what is happening to the people. I am afraid that I came to the conclusion some time ago that the majority of people who've designated themselves as leaders can't lead, don't lead, and don't deserve to lead, because I don't think what is happening to their country and their people matters. So what do? You can't sit back and say, well, that's terrible, that's just too bad, we can't do anything. And I think one of the questions is, what can the region do? What can South Sudan's neighbors do? On the one hand, I think there's a lot they can do. They've engaged to some extent with having troops and a presence on the ground. Politically, they have engaged consistently and persistently in negotiations and trying again and again and again to get people to agree on just some basics that would create some breathing room. There's also been talk at times of the need for there to be some kind of extra peacekeeping or peace enforcement force in South Sudan. There have been pressures to put in place some sort of regional sanctions so that the money that is being siphoned out is not siphoned out, but in the hopes that maybe if it threatens somebody's wallet, it will cause them to change. I think depending on the particular state of play at a particular time, any of those tools may be necessary, but I think it's not as simple as simply saying to the region, you should do X or you should do Y. I think we've got to give other countries in the region a lot of credit. They have tried, they have worked on this, they've expended time and energy and resources and blood in trying to get South Sudan to save itself from itself. So the question becomes, okay, so like, well, okay, that's pretty depressing. So what do we do? I think there are a couple things. I think putting pressure on, advocating, asking the region to step in and do more, asking the region for a plan. They may have more expertise than others do and may have a view on what the thing is. But I think in order to do that, we got to do two things. I think sending a very, very strong message that the women of South Sudan aren't going to take this anymore will get people's attention, inside and outside. This conflict has been overwhelmingly driven and fueled and directed by men. There have been a lot of boys and men who've been victims of it, don't get me wrong. But the fact of the matter is, women are almost completely and totally excluded from trying to be part of the solution because a very, very limited grip on any semblance of power. And if you look at movements in Latin America, for example, there have been instances where women rose up in a very big way, whether it was the mothers of the disappeared or other cases, and it was really, really powerful. So I think one is send a message that the women of South Sudan aren't going to take it anymore, don't deserve it, and know how to rebuild it, and know how to own and build peace. There are all sorts of creative ways to send that message, and I think you'll get people's attention. The second is to send a signal to other leaders in the region or the AU or whomever it may be that if they're willing to have the political courage to take additional steps to try to bring South Sudan under control, that we will give them thanks and credit for them. One of the things, I've been in government, I've tried to negotiate things, I've tried to work them diplomatically, including South Sudan, for a long, long time. I've been an advocate in my life, I am one again. And one of the things that I'm reminded of now as an advocate is that as hard as we may want to push politicians and decision makers to do the right thing, that's effective. But if you also tell them that if you get out there and show political courage, we will give you credit, that matters. It matters because they're human. Everybody likes to be acknowledged and thanked for doing something, but it also matters because they're political. It's a political risk. South Sudan is not a winning enterprise if you're a politician. It's a hard country to handle. So I think send the message that if you support us, we will support you. We will back you. We will thank you. I think that matters. A lot of tactics that could be used. Put together a powerful delegation of South Sudanese women. Go all over the region. Get yourselves in front of the press. And just let everybody know, nope, we're not going to take this anymore. It's not just a message, we're suffering, this is terrible, that's all true. But you got to be fair, but you got to be fierce. And tell them, no more. South Sudan belongs to all of you. You deserve it. It is a beautiful, beautiful country. And all of its women and all of its children deserve better. And its men and its boys. And so I would just say, get out there in front and demand it. And stand up and be seen, and we'll help you get there. Thanks.